こんばんは、フォレックス TV ニューヨークのレミです。4月22日火曜日の為替レポートニューヨークレビューをお伝えします。22日のアメリカ株式市場は続落しました。ダウ工業株30週平均は前日104ドル71セント安の12720ドル31セントで終えた。ナスダック総合株価指数は31点10ポイント安の2376.94で終えた。本日の取引で原油先物が最高値を更新しました。また3月のアメリカ中古住宅販売件数は前月比 2% 減少しました。ニューヨーク外国為替市場で円相場は続伸しました。投資家のリスク許容度低下の思惑が出て、円は対ドルで一時102円67銭まで上昇しました。ドル円は前日比25銭円高、ドル安の102円95銭から103円5銭で取引を終えた。ユーロ円は前日比40銭円安、ユーロ高の164円65銭から75銭で取引を終えた。またユーロドルは初めて 1.60 ドル台に乗せました。ユーロは対ドルで一時 1.6020 ドルとユーロ導入来の最高値を更新しました。それではDailyFX.comのキャシリーさんとのインタビューをご覧ください。
Well, in today's session, we saw Euro dollar finally break through 160, which is a technical as well as psychological level that market players have been watching. But given inflation concerns over in the Eurozone and also crude oil pennies away from the 120 barrel mark.And also a risk of a rate hike from the ECB, where do you see euro dollar headed?
Well, you know, this is quite a big move for the euro dollar. It seems like the fourth time is the charm because that currency pair certainly has tried to break above 160 for the past, you know, four or five trading days and has finally done so. But if you take a look at the price action of the euro,post the break, it's not as impressive as the move when we saw the euro break 150. Basically, back when the euro broke 150, the currency pair proceeded to surge 144 pips on top of 150 that very same day. But when it came to this morning's break, it broke above 160, went to 160.19, and it failed. So,It remains to be seen whether this strength can be sustained because unlike 150 where we had a whole bunch of option barriers at that price level, there really isn't too much going on at 160. So I think that even though we could see a bit more dollar weakness, it won't be the same move that we saw when we first had that break of 150 where over the course of a few weeks, the euro dollar was at 156, basically.
Okay, and before we move on to the other currency pairs, I do want to get your take on where the ECB is headed in terms of their monetary policy.
Well, the big question right now is whether the ECB will make a rate hike before a rate cut. I think that this is not possible because today we had the German Banking Association essentially bail out, you know, one of the larger banks in Germany. I think it's called like Dusseldorf, you know, something like that. ButThe issue with that is a lot of German banks may be hiding some of their losses as suggested by the depressed level LIBOR rates. So if the German banks start to report losses, the ECB will have no option in terms of interest rates. They'll have to keep them unchanged because the financial sector would still be struggling.And that's why I think that even though inflationary pressures are very strong and the recent rise in oil prices will make a rate cut also extremely likely, I think that rate hike is not something that the ECB is contemplating at this point.
以上、DailyFX.com のキャシリンさんとのインタビューでした。Forex TV ニューヨークのレミがお伝えしました。最新の為替情報については、Forex TV Japan をご覧ください。